How you doing? Mark Brennan for jamplay.com. Good to have you back with me. Hope you're enjoying the basic electric guitar series we're doing here. Today we're going to start getting our hands on the guitar and start making some sounds, start putting the strings in motion. We're going to do a lesson on right-hand technique. So we're not going to do anything with the left hand with this lesson. We're just going to focus strictly on the right hand. We're going to first of all talk about holding the pick, very important. Pretty simple thing. You just pick the pick up, but I'll give you some ideas on the proper way to hold the pick. And then we're going to get into putting the strings in motion. I'm going to introduce to you a series of exercises I put together. They will be in the supplemental content. You can pull them up, make a copy of them, and use them as you watch the video. You're going to find that these exercises are going to help your control of the pick on the string. We're not going to talk about speed. We're not going to be doing any speed picking. We're not going to be doing a lot of down-up picking, although one of the exercises involves a down-up stroke. We're just going to be talking about getting the feel of the pick on the string, picking the proper string, and picking the proper group of strings. Okay? Okay, so we will get at it. We'll start off with holding the pick, and we'll be right back. Thanks. Okay, we're back. Now let's pick up our guitar pick. Now you probably go into the music store and notice the myriad of picks they have hanging on the wall or in one of these display boxes. There's many different sizes and colors and thicknesses. And you're probably wondering, well, what pick should I use? Well, since we're pretty much starting off as a beginner, I would suggest that you start with this is a Gretsch medium, but the basic Fender medium. Start off with the standard size pick and try the medium thickness. Okay, just has a little bit of give to it. This is a good place to start, okay? Then as you get more stylized and you get more advanced in your playing, you're going to find that certain picks work better for you. If you're going to be playing a lot of single note, fast stuff, you might want to use a thicker, maybe smaller pick. If you're getting into acoustic guitar, you might want to use a thinner pick that has a little more give to it. But for now, why don't we just start with the Fender medium? There's a lot of different styles of picks. This is the Dunlop nylon. This is cool because it has some grippy stuff on it to help you hang on to the pick. That's always a good thing. This is about the same thickness as a medium, but that's a nice pick. That's a standard size. I've got the Cool pick, which I use when I play acoustic guitar. The thing I like about the Cool pick is it's got the gritty surface, and it feels real secure in between my fingers. I'm not going to lose it. A little bit thinner with the acoustic, okay? But we're playing electric guitar, so let's start off with a little bit thicker pick. Now, I use the Dunlop Tortex picks, which is, a lot of people would refer to these as a jazz pick. This is cool for me now because I do a lot of single note stuff. It's a little thicker for more precision picking, and it's easier to get my thumb on the string for artificial harmonics, pinched harmonics, should I say. So I've really settled into the Tortex. That's the 0.88 millimeter. That's my pick of choice on the electric guitar. So, you know, you can experiment with different picks as you work with these exercises I'm going to show you. But again, as a good starting point or reference, try the good old Fender mediums. They're good. Just like a mid-thickness standard size pick. Okay? All right, now real quick, we're going to talk about how to hold the pick. Let me use the Fender medium. Now, when I'm showing students how to hold a pick, I talk about the natural shape of the hand and how you would shake somebody's hand. You're not going to bend your wrist. You're going to keep your wrist straight, and you're not going to curl the wrist. You're going to keep it flat. Okay, so that's what we want to do. Now, all I'm going to do is I'm going to curl that index finger till that first knuckle is right under my thumb. going to bring the thumb down and set it right on that first knuckle of my index finger. And then the pick will go right in like that with the point facing straight down. Okay, that's the way to do it. Now, this to me is the best way to do it. Might want to get into a good habit right away with holding the pick. A lot of people tend to let the pick get on the more on the flat part of the back of the tip of the finger, and then they grab it with the thumb, and what it ends up doing is they get into a weird wrist position, and you don't want to do that. You want to get the pick more on the side of the index, hold it with the thumb, and then when you get into the good right hand playing position, the wrist is flat. It's not protruding, and it's right in the perfect position to play, and it just feels real natural and relaxed. Now, I want you to do this. I want you to squeeze the pick slightly, okay? Now, what I'm feeling is tension in my hand, in my fingers, and up into my forearm. All those muscles tense up. Now, I want you to relax, okay? Now, I still have the pick. I'm not going to lose the pick. But everything here is relaxed. All right, that's very important. You want to keep the forearm, the hand, the fingers relaxed. With these fingers, you can either curl them in or you can protrude them a little bit, rest them on the pick guard if you feel comfortable with that. Some different things, like if I'm strumming like on an acoustic guitar, I'll curl the fingers in so I don't have any obstruction with the fingers. If I'm doing single note stuff, I kind of like to put my fingers resting on the pick guard to anchor my hand for more precision, okay? But again, it's the relaxation, that's the important thing. Okay, you don't want to be squeezing the pick. Squeeze the pick to feel the tension, loosen it up, and it's all relaxed. Okay, so grab a pick, find a pick that you like, that feels comfortable. Again, I suggest the standard size pick. And we'll get on to some picking exercises to get your right hand going. Okay, so be right back. Okay, so we talked about the pick. Just remember to relax, hold it on the side of your index under your thumb. Now what we're going to do is we're going to start putting strings in motion. We know the names of the open strings. Okay, we've gone over those. And you're gonna have to reference back to your tab reading lesson that we did. Make sure that you know how to read tab. Now the supplemental material for this lesson is there for you to inspect and download. Real simple tab, it's all open strings. Okay, you just have to remember about the proximity of the lines. The bottom line is your bottom E string, the one closest to the ceiling. What the heck's with that? I don't know, but it's the lowest pitched string, so we call it the low E string. And that ends up being the bottom line on the tab, okay? Now, what these exercises are going to help you do is learn how to put the pick on the right string, okay? So when you're playing, whether it be a single note thing or double stops, three note power chords, four or five note chords, you're acquiring the confidence to pick the right string. I've seen a lot of students go through a lot of frustration of playing, you know, more intermediate stuff, but they keep picking the wrong string. Okay, they'll have the finger on the right string, but they'll pick the wrong string. Okay. Or else they'll strum a chord, I'll tell them to strum a chord from the root, and they'll be strumming it from the string below. Okay, so these exercises are designed for you to get pick control, get control of the strings that you want to pick. Okay, not working for speed here. We're not going to be doing any alternate picking except for one exercise down here. I'm doing an alternate arpeggio kind of picking thing. But these are designed for you to get confidence with your right hand. Okay, so you don't have to worry about keep hitting the wrong string, okay? Because later on, the next lessons are going to involve actual notes. We're going to get our left hand on the guitar. We're going to be playing C major scales and melodies. So we're going to be focusing on the left hand, and you want to have pretty good confidence with your right hand to hit the right string. Okay, So let's look at these. The first one, pretty simple, pretty straightforward. You start on the low E string. We're going to pick it four times. Then we're going to move on to each subsequent string higher up to the high E string. Four strokes each. And we'll do it about 80 beats per minute with our metronome. Okay, so what I want you to do, you do have your metronome, correct? Good. All right. Set it at 80. Now my Dr. Beat has the high pitch beat on beat one. Okay, a lot of people call that the downbeat. Okay, so you always want to start on one. Feel the beat of the metronome. Might I digress for a second? Dennis Hodges did a really, really cool suggestion on one of his lessons about feeling the groove of the metronome. You might want to check that out. He set his metronome at a real slow beat, and he makes the sound of the metronome disappear with a stroke of muffled string. So check out Dennis Hodges' lesson with the metronome. The idea is to lock in with the metronome, feel the pulse of the metronome. Okay? I always have my students tap their foot. Now, we're not going to be doing a lot of foot tapping here because you can't see my foot. But I'm a believer of foot tapping, so you might want to tap your foot to the beat. Okay, so let's get started. We're going to use all down strokes. Let me demonstrate it. One, two. So we start with the low E. Now I'm going to watch. Don't worry about letting the strings ring because we're playing clean, no distortion. Okay, then we'll repeat as often as you like. Now I'm going to watch because this is new to me. Okay, I want the hand-eye coordination. Help me out on this. Now eventually, I'm going to try to look away and see how well I can do this without looking at my right hand. If I screw up, I'm not going to get too worried about it because, again, I'm learning. So I'm going to look back down just to make sure. Go through it one more time. Try to look me straight in the eye and do it. Okay, so the idea is look at yourself doing it. Watch your right hand do it, then look away. Stay in the groove of the metronome. Okay, now they get a little more difficult as we go along. Okay, now the next one, do it once for you. We're going to skip strings. We're going to start with the low E, then we're going to move to the D, back to the A, to the G. Now I'm looking at the music. That's another good thing. I try to get my students to keep their eye on the music. Now make the jump down to the low sixth string. So this is a little more tricky because you have to skip strings. Finding the right string. If I screw up or I don't feel confident, I'm going to keep looking. Don't be afraid to look down. Then look away. Okay? All right, so you get the idea what's going on here. Okay, it's not for speed. What we're trying to do is find the right string with our pick and play to the groove of the metronome. Okay? Now, the next exercise, we skip two strings. Okay, we go from the E, we'll just kind of go through these quickly. So you see what I'm doing? It's more difficult because there's larger breaks in the strings. Okay, now this next one is sort of an arpeggio picking. Okay, we're going to skip strings. We're going to start with the low E with a downstroke, and then we're going to go to the D string with an upstroke. Okay, then we'll go back to the fifth string A with a down, upstroke on the third string, downstroke on the fourth string, upstroke on the second string, downstroke on three, and then upstroke on E. Again, don't worry about the strings ringing freely. Just don't use distortion with these exercises. It'll sound like a muddled mess, but. Fast either, just do them evenly. Establish good rhythm for yourself right off the bat, even with simple exercises like this. Rhythm is the most important thing for any musician. Really, I tell you, you can have all the technique in your left hand to impress the world, but if you're rhythmically not solid, you're not going to impress anybody. And conversely, If you really don't have a lot of left-hand technique, but you're solid with your right hand, you know, the place is going to get up and dance, and you're going to rock the place just because you have a solid right hand. So notice how all the teachers on the website, we all use metronomes. We all stress the use of a metronome. It's real important. Establish good rhythm for yourself right off the bat. I have a lot of students who come to me that can play, but I'm spending all the lessons working on their rhythm, going back to stuff that they can play, teaching them how to play with a metronome, tapping your foot, playing evenly. It's real important. Okay, let's get on with it. Now, as you look down at the supplemental music, we get to the multiple string thing. So we'll take a break here, keep working, get real comfortable with the single note stuff, and then we'll come back and we'll introduce some multiple string exercises. Okay, have fun. Practice, practice, practice. Thanks. Okay, Mark Brennan for jamplay.com. Hope you're enjoying the series here. Welcome back. We're going to expand on our pick control exercises. Okay, we're going to start introducing multiple note exercises here. So hopefully you're pretty comfortable with the single string stuff. I would suggest you get real comfortable with that if you have to slow the metronome down a little bit. Don't have a problem with that. Go ahead and slow the metronome down as slow as it has to be, but make sure that you keep it even. And make sure you're comfortable and confident with these single note exercises, because the double note things are going to be a little more challenging for you. Okay. Okay. So let's get on to some two string exercises now. Now these are good because they're good for power chord playing. A lot of power chords are two note. We do three note power chords also, but you're going to find in guitar playing is a lot of double note stuff. I call them double stops, where you're attacking two strings. So if you look at the next exercise down here, we're going to start on the low E and A string, okay, and we're going to pick two strings together. Now again, can't stress it enough, stay relaxed, okay? Make sure you're holding the pick correctly, okay? You don't want to be doing this, okay? You're going to be all out of control if you're like this. Get the pick in here. Keep it flat. Don't bend. Don't protrude. Just real natural. Squeeze the pick to feel the tension. Then let it loose and just really relax. And we're going to start with the bottom two. Let's get the metronome going. Okay, now I got this at 80. Go ahead and slow it down if you feel more comfortable doing it a little slower. Okay, so we're going to move up to 5 and 4, 4 and 3, 3 and 2, and 2 and 1. Don't be afraid to look down if you don't feel comfortable with it. Get the hand-eye coordination. And then what happens is you're training your hand the proximity of where the strings are. So now at this point, I can look at my audience. I can look at the music. I can look at my left hand. I don't have to constantly be buried in my right hand like this. I don't want to worry about looking at my right hand all the time. Okay, so the next exercise involves more string skips. We're going to do 6 and 5, and then 4 and 3, 5 and 4, 3 and 2, back to 4 and 3, and then up to 1 and 2. Give yourself a countdown, feel the groove of the metronome. Now we're going to skip to here, 3 and 2, 4 and 3, and then 1 and 2. Okay, be patient with yourself. Take it one exercise at a time. Okay? It's easiest to go up in sequential order the strings before you start the string skipping. Okay? Get real comfortable with the going in sequential order first, then try the string skipping ones. Okay, the next one, you're skipping two strings now. Okay, we're going to go from the E to B, or E to A, sorry, to the G, B, back to A, D, and then up to B, E. Notice how I'm keeping my eyes on the music. Okay, I'm confident with my right hand. Okay, now the three notes. A lot of times we're playing three-note power chords. You're playing triads, which are three-note chords, on any group of strings. Okay, so these exercises are good. They'll get you going on three notes. First one kind of works in sequential order, where you're starting on the bottom three. Now, I got to use a little more wrist action now. And I probably say, Mark, well, we're strumming now, right? Well, yes, we are, because we're doing three notes. We're not doing double stops. We're doing three notes, so we're actually playing chords now. So again, relaxation is the key. Work with the wrist. Don't start doing this with your forearm. Don't try to do this. This is not right. Okay, you want to use your wrist. So when we start strumming full chords, it'll be more of the wrist action. Okay, then we get on to four note chords. Four note groups of open strings. We're going to start with the bottom four. Then the middle four, I call it. Then the top four. Now go back to the middle four and then start over. Here's the bottom four, the middle four, and the top four. Okay, so there's your four string. Then finally we have a five string exercise. Okay. So again, these get a little more difficult, but we need a little more wrist action now. Okay, so now I'm going to work the bottom five and then the top five. Again, this is good for different chord voicings that you might encounter in the course of a chord progression. I mean, because let's face it, let's be realistic, we're going to be doing chord progressions that are going to involve any number of different groups of strings, and different numbers of strings. So you have to get confident with the number of strings that you're picking. Okay, so that finishes it up. Notice I have a big six string open at the very end of the exercises. Okay, so again, get comfortable with the single note ones first, then work your way through the multiple string exercises. One more thing before we go, I wanted to show you. I wanted to explain to you how to do the difference between a rest stroke and a free stroke with your flat pick. Okay. Now, when you free stroke, let's go back to a single note thing. You're going to let the pick just stroke freely over the top of the next adjacent string. Okay. Again, I'm relaxed. Just letting the pick snap the string a little bit and going over the top of the strings. Now we're going to rest stroke, where the angle of your hand or the angle of your pick changes slightly. Okay, we're going to turn ever so slightly, so now the follow through of the pick comes to rest on the next adjacent string. Okay, so if you just kind of practice doing this, now again, relaxation is the key here. Okay, you don't want to be going, you know, you're pushing the string and snapping it like that. Think of it like a bristle of a paintbrush. So it has a little give, and you're getting a nice clean tone and you're coming to rest. And you're saying, Mark, what's the point of this? We can get more natural accents in our playing, especially power chord work, if we learn how to do a rest stroke. Okay, so I can practice any one of these with the rest stroke. Okay, see there's a little single note thing. If I go to the two note, see I'm rest stroking the two note chord now. A lot of people have a tendency to do this. Whoops. You know, where they let the string they're trying to come to rest on snap. But you have to learn the control. A lot of it's relaxation. Again, I keep saying that word, but just let the pick fall on the next adjacent string. Three note, same thing. The next adjacent string up is where the pick comes to rest. There's a four note chord. Okay, then the five note. Now obviously when you're working on the top strings, there's no way to rest stroke a chord like that. So you just let it come free. So practice it both ways. Practice it free stroke. And then you're gonna notice with the rest stroke you get a lot more pointed, more accented attack, which is louder. Okay? And you'll see when we start learning power chords, lessen up the road a little bit. I really like the rest stroke power chords when I'm trying to accent them. And if I want to play them softer, I'll free stroke. Okay, so try these exercises with the rest stroke and the free stroke. And we'll be right back and we'll wrap up and look forward to our next lesson. Thanks. Okay. Let's wrap up our pick control exercise lesson. Hope you're enjoying it. Now, it's not very musical, right? Just a bunch of open strings. But there's some real important things going on here. Of course, it's the getting control of your right hand, learning to relax when you play with the right hand, and establishing good rhythm right off the bat. Okay. So do this a little bit every day. The benefits are going to be quite immediate because there's a lot of things that you're going to be doing with your guitar career that all this pick control exercises are going to help. Single note stuff, soloing, written melodies, power chords, double stops and triple stops. And then your strumming of chords, controlling groups of strings, being able to strum the chord from the root of the chord and not all six strings just haphazardly. You need to control the pick and stay relaxed, okay? Just work the exercises at your own pace. Get comfortable with the single note things first, like I mentioned before, okay? That'll give you the confidence to move on, okay? And once you're confident with your right hand, it's really going to help once we start getting into the left-hand stuff, which, by the way, is what we're going to look forward to in our next lesson. We are going to start getting our left hand on the fretboard. I'm going to talk about proper left-hand positioning, getting on the tips of your fingers, proper fretting of the notes, a lot of stuff we need to talk about and understand. I see from forum posts that a lot of people have difficulty with their left hand not getting clean tones, buzzing, bumping adjacent strings. We'll get into all that. And we're going to learn the natural notes in the first position. We're going to learn the C major scale. And then we'll get onto the A minor scale because once you learn the natural notes in the first position, what I mean by the first position is the first four frets of the guitar neck, by the way, the fretboard. So we'll look at the first position, learn the natural notes, and then we'll learn C major and A minor, and we'll learn a couple simple melodies, and that's going to get you going. That's going to get you the confidence to start doing a lot of other cool stuff. Okay, have fun. That's the important thing. Stay confident. Don't get discouraged. If you're having a rough time with something and you keep banging your head against the wall, to quote a Pink Floyd. Just take a break, put your guitar down, regroup and come back. Make good use of your practice time. Set goals for yourself. Give yourself confidence and get something out of every practice session. It gives you something to look forward to when you come back. It's just slowly building the confidence and building on everything that you've learned up to this point. Okay? All right, so have fun. Practice hard. Get confident and direct your questions to my forum. Okay, be happy to answer any of your questions, any of your concerns, and I will see you on our next lesson. I'm Mark Brennan for jamplay.com, and rock on.